Only marriage could turn a missing spatula into an act of war. So this started with everything has a place in the house. And I did dishes finally for the first time, and I don't keep track, but I put a spatula in the wrong drawer, the non-spatula drawer. So when my wife was cooking, she went into the what she thinks is the spatula drawer, opened it up, and the missing spatula caused a war of words, a war of places, and a war over where a spatula is supposed to go. And she said, "Why do you not put the tools in the right drawer?" And I may have said something to the effect of, "You never use the tools right anyway. What does it matter where they're at?" Which then led to a conversation. That actually was a conversation starter.
This has nothing to do with the spatula. Keep going, sorry.
Which led to a conversation about how I never put things away, and how I then relayed to her that she doesn't really know where things go as it is because you don't put the right tools together, which is a clear indication of your level of intelligence, which then led to what I call World War Home. Because suddenly all the fur was flying at that point, you know. She's like, maybe the garage would be more organized if, you know, you just put stuff away where it belongs. Does it even have a home? You don't even know where those homes are at. You don't even use that stuff. Why does it need to have a home? So, yes, only marriage can a missing spatula turn into an act of war. And it did. It turned into an aggressive conversation where I was just mentioning that, you know, she doesn't know where the stuff goes anyway. And she doesn't really pay attention.
All right. That's a lot to unpack.
Over a spatula.
But I'm going to start with... I don't know if you're the dumbest person I've ever met in my entire life, but you're in the top two.
Thank you. Okay. I'm number one or two. Finally.
Okay. So now, I have had this conversation. Now, part of this conversation, I was laughing because I had this conversation with my three-year-old.
Great.
She gets stuff out, and then I say to her, her name, yeah. Right? Little one. What do we do with our tools when we're done?
Uh-huh.
And she says, "We put them back where we found them, Daddy." Good. Why do we do that? So that we know where they are the next time we need them. So frankly, right, the good deed that you had by putting the dishes away and then putting the tools, or in this case, utensils,
mm-hmm.
back where they don't belong is a recipe to create the conversation or the question that your wife asked, because she was expecting to find the tool that she needed in the place where that tool is supposed to be.
That's not where it's supposed to be in the first place.
We've talked about...
No, it's not where it's supposed to be.
We have talked about...
It wasn't. It's in the wrong drawer.
We have spatulas that are in drawers. We have spatulas that are in the little, like, utensil holder bucket thing
that sits on the counter.
Yes. We have tongs that are in drawers, and we have tongs that are in the bucket thing. We have ladles in the drawers and ladles in the bucket thing.
I still want to walk 50 feet to grab my spatula.
But that's a conversation about functionality. But if you're going to, rearrange the kitchen in a manner that your wife does not functionally want it rearranged in, then what you are saying is you're going to take over the majority of the duties, a la cooking and cleaning and the rest of it. Because were your wife to go outside and borrow a socket wrench to fix a post, because why not? And then she put it back in the box that holds the trash bags that you use to pick up lawn clippings. And then you went to, let's say, drain the oil out of your car because you wanted to change the oil. And you couldn't find your socket wrench, and you seemed to be missing one of the sockets.
The 10 millimeter, set. You know what I'm talking about.
Right? Would you ask your wife where she put it?
Because, most likely.
Because then she could tell you.
Very politely, I would say. Because
then she could tell you.
Where the hell is the...
And then if she said, I put it in the box that holds the black plastic bags that you use for grass clippings because that's where I deem it is to be.
It would be heresy.
Then you would understand the ridiculousness of what you just said to your wife about a spatula. When clearly...
Kitchen and garage are two different things.
When clearly the proper answer could have gone something like, you're right, honey. I put it in a place that I thought would be helpful, and clearly that wasn't. You wouldn't even have to say another word. And you'd probably...
I'm not following.
And you'd probably get burnt bacon out of it.
Oh, dear God. Don't even start with the burnt bacon. She's never been allowed to touch bacon since the last bacon accident.
Look, we just put a podcast out. This is not a hill to die on. It's a spatula. You're going to use it to make an egg.
When you start a war, you go to war to win.
That's fine. I guess you can win the war against
George
your
Patton
wife.
Here. I went George Patton on
you
it.
You can go Sherman.
Did.
You can do that.
Just started rolling over hills.
Still your wife.
Right. I'm like, I'm going to die on this hill, and we're going to die on this hill, and we're going to die on this hill.
You still have to go home.
Yeah. Right?
And eventually you're going to go home, and you're going to eat the food that she's making you. You're gonna hire a food taster?
Why does this taste funny?
Maybe you should write a job description and start putting that out there.
Could you imagine an ad going in the paper looking for someone to cook all of the meals my wife is incapable of making?
No.
That's
not what
pay
I said.
Pay is decent.
I said you should put a job out there that said, I'm looking for somebody to taste my food because clearly my wife is going to poison me. And frankly, right, you'd probably get some people that would apply for it.
I don't like where this is going, but I was right. She was wrong. Anyway, if you like what you've seen here, go ahead and subscribe to our channel. I'm just not going to fight this battle with you anymore because I was right. You know why I was right? Because the spatula belongs right next to the stove, not with the other silver. I should stop.
The backhoe is already in motion.
Start digging that hole. Right. It's like washing her jeans and shrinking them. Which... I quasi-apologized about that one. Perhaps washing jeans on hot water.
I'm just wondering how long before you have a koi pond.
Why is that funny? Because we're having the patio poured next week, and she was like, what are we going to do with the space in between the trees and the fire pit?
I know. Just have her send me a note, and I'll let you know.
Ignore everything that you've seen here today. Do not listen to the man next to me. Whatever you do, do not listen to the man next to me. Guys, if you like what you've seen here and you want to see my life continue to go down into a series of flames like a jet engine flying through the air and falling to the ground, continue to watch this channel. Subscribe to it. That way you get notified because I will be going down in some sort of horrible sound like, and you want to be there for it. Also, check out ourcommunitynow.com because we have stories where we can actually give decent marital advice, even though it has actually no real bearing on life, and the stories that make you feel good and the things that are going on in your community, because clearly I have no clue, and I'm okay with that. But I'm Josh, and he's still here. He won't go away. My wife hates this.